Hi, this is Linda, your Back in the Groove Again coach, with another tip, insight, call it what you want. And I'm realizing I should be doing these live because these are so good. Anyways, I've been thinking about some of the ways that I've been, that I was behaving in the last few years. And I'll be very, very specific. I'll give you a very specific example. A few years ago, I had a friend living at my house. You know, he had some challenges. He was having a difficult time. And so I told him, you know what, if you need a place to stay, come and live at my place. And at that time, we had had a more intimate relationship. Like prior to him coming to live with me, we had had an intimate relationship. And when he did come in to live at my house in his own room, you know, we were just friends. And I remember how angry I was when I found out that, and this is going to sound really terrible, when I found out that he was eating my peanut butter. I know it sounds really bad, but I remember, it sounds bad now when I think about it, but at the time, when I saw my jar of peanut butter going slowly down, I was so upset. I was. And, you know, I told him, that's my peanut butter. Why don't you just get your own peanut butter, you know? And it's so funny now when I think about it, but seriously, this was, I don't know, 5 years ago or something like that. I can't remember, but, and it wasn't just the peanut butter. It was other things, too, that he was, you know, taking from me. And of course, you know, at that time, we had agreed that he was, you know, renting the room, he had to buy his own groceries, you know, he was responsible for his own stuff. So in my mind, you know, it was clear that my peanut butter is my peanut butter. And but so the point is that at that time, several years ago, I was livid when I noticed that he was taking something that was belonging to me, stealing. And that's how I perceived it at that time. So, and I think part of it was the nature of our relationship and you know, the history of our relationship that was coming into play with my attitude and my perception of what he was doing. So fast forward to, you know, now, I'm a homeowner, and in the last year and a half, I've decided to rent rooms again. And it happens that I have three younger men. I know it sounds kind of crazy, older woman, younger men. My friends think I'm a cougar woman, but, or a cougar. But anyways, no, I'm not. So they have their own rooms, and the idea is that they buy their own groceries, of course, you know, because I'm not going to buy groceries for everybody. They have to buy their own groceries. But I've noticed, and this is kind of like what I want to address here, I've noticed that my ideas of what's mine and what's yours and what's ours is changing. You know, yesterday I took some coffee, and I thought it was from my can of coffee. But, you know, and the young man was in the kitchen, and I said, is that my coffee? He says, no, I actually bought that because I've been taking some of your coffee. So he bought another can. And I thought, right, why don't I buy the next can? And it wasn't like that. Like my attitude around what's mine, what's yours, what's ours hasn't just changed, you know, just like that. I would say that it's because I've made some conscious decisions of letting go. And this is what I want to talk about. Letting go. And I mean, really letting go. Now, letting go for me means, you know, it, whatever it is, you know, like the peanut butter thing, which sounds silly, but it not bothering me that it's okay and truly okay if he has peanut butter. Now, this is an example, but yesterday I talked about communication and I talked about, you know, that it's possible that we have frustrations coming up at this period in our lives because of the changes, because of now we're now spending more time with our loved ones at home. And so it's possible that we might need to talk about certain things. And so, you know, I think it's healthy. We have to talk about things that upset us, that frustrate us, so that at least the person we're talking to can take that information and decide what they want to do with it, right? Because we're not responsible for their change. We're only responsible to express what we want, what we need. And they have to figure out if that's in their best interest or not. So this letting go, I'm going to say that to decide what's truly important to you. You know, what's really, really important? Like, honestly, when I think about the peanut butter thing, oh, seriously, it's like I'm almost ashamed to talk about it and mention it. I really am. Because I remember 5 years ago when I was talking to my kids about it or talking to somebody else about it, they would say, so what? Right? Like, so what? And really, it is, so what? So think about what is truly important to you. And if this is something that is definitely important to you, then I encourage you to talk about it. And, you know, to work with a coach to figure out the best way of approaching it. But if it's not that important to you, it's not going to make a huge difference in your life, then let it go. Let it go completely. Meaning, don't bring it back up. Don't hold on to this, well, I kind of, you know, told you a little while ago that I didn't like it. No, if you're going to let it go completely, right? Let's not do this passive-aggressive stuff where, no, it's okay, you can have my peanut butter, but then go, no, that's not what I'm talking about. I'm talking about being absolutely fully aware that the decision that you're making is something that you're okay with, absolutely okay. So okay that you're loving this person for wanting to share your things, for wanting to share. And you'll notice that the more that you are okay with it, that you're happy, and that you're not holding on to any grudges, the more that the type of energy will be felt by the other people in your household. And they might even decide to let go of certain things that they might have been holding on to. You don't really know unless you have that conversation, you know. But your happiness and your joy and your sense of joie de vivre is going to be felt by the other people. So talk about things that bother you. Let go of the things that really don't matter. You know what I mean? Seriously. I mean, seriously, I'll let it go. And that's the tip. So this is Linda G. Robert, your Back in the Groove Again coach. Quite happy with the changes that she's gone through in the last little while. And if you do want more information on my services, please do go to my website. I would love to be your Back in the Groove Again coach. Now, I do work primarily with midlife people, midlife women, leaders in midlife. But you know what? If you want me to be your coach, I'd love to be your coach. And go to my website for more details. Thanks. Have a great day now. Bye-bye.